addresses their body, but they just make it think it came from the dog gods and zap them for whining. And you don't have to stress. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to respond. And by the way, they can smell if you feel sorry for them from across the house. They can smell that. So don't sit there and feel sorry for them and feel bad that you're giving a vibration in their neck to knock them off their tracks a little bit and get them to calm down. All right. So if you do that, I've actually experienced with one of my dogs, a roommate, feeling sorry for him and coming over to my fiance and going, I pray to God that she's doing the right thing for that dog. He's been whining all day. And I'm like, the dog came to me because the dog whines all day, even with the owners there. There's nothing wrong with the dog. And of course, the dog escalated. And that was the day he ripped up the blanket that covered up his crate. Yeah. And the next day she kept over and kept shushing him. And so he ripped up the next blanket that was covering his crate. And he rarely ever does that at his own home and didn't do that until she started feeling sorry for him and interacting with him. So folks, don't be a shubster like my roommate. Don't do it. Don't do that. Get yourself a $35 vibration collar and fix the problem and just teach the dog to relax. Address the body, okay? Same thing, you can use the same kind of concept out in the field if you're walking your dog, if you don't use a prong collar or the prong collar is not working, that sort of thing, yeah, which for some dogs it doesn't, they become desensitized. So sometimes that's better to use like a vibration collar. It's very awkward and something they're not used to, and that it kind of knocks them off their socks a little bit without hurting them. So if the dog gets to the point where they're so excited that they're actually howling or screaming, you will have to use a very low level shock, whatever level that is, okay? And I have no problem with that if you're doing it just for those moments. Some people, your timing's got to be right. But if you just do it for like, if you miss the whining part and it escalated screaming, you got to go to shock. The vibration is just not going to work for them. So I would just have a collar that is like, does both for you. You can switch modes if you know, you walked in from home and all of a sudden they're screaming in their crate, then just do that, okay? And don't respond, don't say anything, and don't say good or anything like that. Don't even walk into the room until they're quiet. So this is one of those things, and this is like a huge deal. That's part of the separation anxiety, all that stuff, and crating is one of the biggest ways you're going to change that separation anxiety. But if you let the dog get wound up or encourage them to get wound up by feeling sorry for them, being stressed out for them, talking to them, either negative or positive, you're making things worse and the anxiety gets more intense. And now we're changing all that vocalization and physicality the dog's doing into not just I'm nervous or afraid, but now I'm demanding to get out. And that can get really violent. I've seen dogs try to break their teeth, and that is our fault. That is not because the crate is bad. It is because we were stupid enough to fall for all of their whining, okay? So when it comes to other means of whining, one of the things that they will do for the reason they'll offer whining behavior is for appeasement. You'll see this all over the internet. Now, here's what appeasement is all about. It's about lowering their status to another dog or person, okay? Which a lot of veterinarians, trainers, all that, they're like, it's just a natural thing for them to do. It is a natural thing for them to do, like any other situation of whining, but I do not want you to encourage it. If your dog ever whines and lowers its head and tucks its tail and pins back its ears to present itself to another dog, end that interaction. Simply walk between them and say, heel. Bring them to come with you, distract them away from you. Your dog in that moment is overreacting. If they're that insecure, we should not encourage the reaction. It's like giving a positive reward of play with another dog after they overly compensated for their status. I don't want you to encourage your dog to be overly compensated. The only time that should happen is if they were being a jerk, the other dog actually corrected them, and then they appeased and lowered themselves. Not in the beginning of the interaction. That is not okay with me. You are encouraging them to be insecure. So do not do that. So So I want you to watch for that. I don't want you to listen to people who are telling you, well, it's an appeasement behavior, so it's okay. No, it shouldn't happen. When you, it's not, when you meet somebody for the first time, you don't sit there and get on your knees and lower your head and kiss their hand and say, I am not worthy to be in your presence. That is not how you meet people. And if you do, you have serious issues and that should not be encouraged. Same with your dog. So make sure that if your dog immediately goes into appeasement, lays down, rolls over, whines, tucks his tail, all that to meet a dog, this should not. You should just end the situation and move on. You should stop having dog-to-dog interactions with your dog, have them stay by your side, keep dogs at a distance, teach them to be okay standing on their four paws or sitting, all right, in a upright position around dogs without direct interaction. I'm just telling you right now. Now, if your dog went and charged another dog and the other dog like nipped him in the neck, oh, that's called a correction, not a punishment, by the way. It's an actual talking to the body situation like we do with the e-collar or the correction collar. Thank you. If your dog just got corrected and then they give the appeasement of a whine and a lowered body and all that stuff, then that's acceptable. And in that moment, depending on how they respond, if they shake it off and they're cool with each other, great. If the other dog who just corrected is now going to overcorrect and do it again, or your dog never recovers, you need to like separate them immediately, okay? So, because if the other dog doesn't accept your dog's appeasement behavior with the whining and all that stuff, then that dog's an a-hole and we need to get out of that. Because your dog should be forgiven. Your dog should experience forgiveness for that behavior. And in that case, that should be rewarded. And if the other dog's not rewarding it, you need to get that your dog away from them. Okay? So the whole concept of saying if it's an appeasement behavior, just accept it. Depends on the context, folks. It really does depend on the context. The other thing that you'll see on the internet all the time about whining is, oh, well, you know, if you give your dog activity all day long and then they won't be that separation anxiety will go away and da-da. BS. Your dog's supposed to know very clearly when they're working and when they're off duty. And their circadian rhythm depends on that. And their ability to digest their food depends on that. And their ability to sleep. I literally just experienced having the last dog that stayed with me. It took 7 days. In spite of my roommate's interference, it took 7 days for the dog to actually sleep through the night and take naps during the day like it's supposed to. It just sat in the crate panicking because his physiology, his owners were very, you know, went through the whole, I'm going to train him to do agility, I'm going to train him to do this, I'm going to train him to do that. And the thing is that the dog never was actually afraid of everything. He's afraid of open space. He's afraid of all these things. And none of that helped him with his fear. And instead, he's learned to be jacked up on hormones all day long and never learned to relax. And so it was literally like watching someone going through, drug rehab when they're detoxing from like cocaine or meth. They're literally just, their body is like trying to fill in those neurotransmitters that are used to being flooded all the time. And it doesn't know what to do and he can't sleep and he's got itchy and he's like panting and like licking and just going crazy. And it's not the dog's fault. In terms of like the dog is intentionally doing anything at that point, he's literally fighting his physiology. And so it was like literally watching a detox happen. And when he slept through the night for the first time, the last night that he stayed there, it was like miraculous. And the next day when we went on the walk, he was not as nervous. He didn't have his ears pinned back. He wasn't licking his chops and panting so hard. He was aware of everything, but he wasn't panicking. It was the first time ever. And it was because his brain had been used to producing all this garbage. And unfortunately, the owners didn't know that giving him lots of attention and giving him lots of free space and getting him lots of toys made it worse. Teach your dog when he's off duty or she's off duty so that she's not constantly on, and they can actually learn to relax and not be full of anxiety. So crating is the number one way that I handle that, but also corrections. You have to address the body. Now, here's a situation where I want you to be aware of. If your dog is on a walk, for instance, on the leash with you, and whines when it sees another dog, make sure you make a correction sound before or at the same time that you correct with the leash or with the e-collar, okay? So the dog knows, your dog knows, that you're the one that bit them in the neck to tell them to knock it off, okay, and take it down a notch, and they don't think the other dog bit them. This is a big problem with leash aggression. It's not the only way it happens, but it's a common way, and the dog is all wound up looking at the other dog. All of a sudden, you correct them without warning them that it's you. They think the other dog they're looking at bit them, and this can cause aggression. Any of these situations with whining, if you do not address it, and I mean talk to the body, i.e. correct, okay, or completely ignore if they're in the crate, but usually that leads to some sort of escalation at some point. It all escalates. It generally just escalates. When they're really young puppies, if you ignore the whining, a lot of times it goes away. But when they're older, it'll escalate to aggression one way or another, even if it's happy excitement. I've seen dogs who are so happy to see me that they lost their shit and started attacking me. Because no one controlled their excitement and let them jump all over people and be aggressive in a sort of a non-scary way. And eventually they just learned to go from 0 to 90 in 2 seconds. And it was not because they have a negative feeling about me. It was because I gave them food and all of a sudden they got so excited they went after me. And this is a problem. So whining should not be given positive rewards without actually separating the correction from something else that you want them to do instead of whining to get your attention, and then reward that. So for instance, with like Rambo, instead of whining to get my attention, I've taught him to sit and wait for me quietly before I give him attention. And that required me correcting his whining, okay, and then getting him to sit. And for attention, I just put him in the crate. I just put him in the crate. If you whine, you go in the crate. But if you sit here, I'll say hello, and I'll then let you come up and on my lap and hang out as long as you stay calm. Okay? So I want you to sort of like understand that you have to address the whining, either by removing them from the situation, like creating them and ignoring them, or address the body directly. And you know, if you're lucky, that it'll go away with ignoring them, but generally, at a certain point, if you're listening to this now, you're too far gone. It's too late. You need to correct. Okay? So the art of whining to get your attention, to possibly get something that they want, to overcompensate for their insecurities and make themselves lower than everybody else, for the possibility of pain or a congenital disease or dysfunction, you need to check that out. But do not give them positive reward for that, and do use corrections because this is a physiology thing, and you need to talk to the physiology before you can train the brain to offer you other behaviors. All right, and if you have anybody in your life who's whining to them, shh, talk to the hand, walk away. Whatever. Don't encourage people to whine with you either, especially those young children. They're going to someday lead the world, and we're screwed if you give in to their whining. All right, I have nothing else to say to you but to remind you that in the dog world, to love is to serve, and so to serve your dog well, that to make sure that you give them little ways every day to serve you, and then you will have the best relationship ever. I'll talk to you next week. Bye.